Ed Skrein, hello.
Hello.
Now, I got quite excited because somebody mispronounced your name to me and called you, which I imagine happens to you a lot,
yes.
Does it, Ed? And they called you Ed Skrein.
Mm.
And I thought...
I've had worse.
But I thought, what a brilliant name to be in films with.
With Skrein?
Yeah.
Yeah, but not spelt like Skrein.
No, no. You are, I mean, you're a rapper. And you're an actor. The question is, Ed, are you triple threat? Can you dance?
No. And I would love... I'm actually a single threat anyway. I can only ever do one thing at once. I haven't made music for a long time. But I would love to do a movie where I could learn like flamenco or salsa or like tango or something, like ballroom dancing. It would be so cool.
Yeah.
You know, us men, we don't necessarily try new things unless we're forced. So I feel like, you know, I would love to be forced to.
Yeah.
I'm sure I could do it.
Yeah, good. I like that belief. I'm just thinking strictly, Ed. All your problems solved.
I'm thinking no way. I'm thinking no way.
Let's talk about Deadpool.
Yes.
It is the new one from Marvel. I know sort of comic book fans who have been more excited about this film than Star Wars. Like, yeah. I mean, it's really, really big for them. How, I mean, did you know about it before the film? Were you kind of a comic book kid?
I was, like, crazy about my comics. From when I was a kid, I used to collect Spawn and X-Men. And, yeah, there's so many, you know, and I loved cartoons, you know, Ninja Turtles and Thundercats and all of that. That was, you know, those guys raised me, you know.
I think they raised all of us in a way. I know what you mean.
You know, and so this is a bit different because it's a real passion project. This means something to me. I am part of the demographic of the fans. What we've done for me is... exactly what Deadpool should have been done. We got the... In fact, how comic book movies should be done, you know? It's irreverent, it's violent, it's rude, it's playful, it's beautiful, it's romantic in some parts, it's everything. And, you know, and it's... what it's not is what you've seen before.
Yeah. Look, my comic book knowledge is appalling. The last comic I read was probably Dennis the Menace. So, but having said that, I just loved how funny it was. I mean, that almost surprised me. And I wondered how it was on set. Like, were you cracking up?
Oh, man, we were cracking
were you?
Up every day. Yeah, it was just so... well, I mean, not all of the scenes.
No,
some
fair.
Some of my scenes specifically are very calm and quiet and dark. We create this romance for every job that we do and feel like, you know, oh, this is great, you know, whether it's kind of like, you know, protecting yourself somewhat. And then by the end of the movie, you can kind of be like, oh, man, this is not what I signed up for. This is not going to be great.
Yeah.
We missed the trick. This could have been good. With this one, the whole way, it was just like, wow, there's just excitement and fun.
I wanted to talk about Ryan because there's quite a bit of nudity from Ryan Reynolds, which also, you know, perked the film up no end, I would actually say. And I wonder, because, I mean, you get, there's quite a lot of fight scenes, one in particular, where Ryan's naked. And I wonder, you know, how much have you seen of little Ryan?
You're very presumptuous saying little Ryan. I mean, you know, you can't really get much more intimate with, you know, with them rolling around, sweaty, rolling around on a floor. We were surrounded by fire and cameras, smoke. It was an extremely dangerous set to be on. But it was, it was intimate. I mean, it was, you know, jokes aside, it was a real bonding experience. You know, we it was such a great day and shooting that stuff was so great. It's so visceral.
Yeah.
You know, so much of the time you see fight sequences and they're either, too elaborate and too fantastical and they don't register with you.
Yeah.
And that's dangerous, having violence where it doesn't, there's no, you know, where it doesn't seem real. And they're always too much CGI and it doesn't seem real. This is just guttural. This is just, you know, Ajax and Deadpool trying to systematically break each other down limb by limb.
Yes.
And it is hardcore and I loved it. I thought it was my favorite scene I've ever... fight sequence I've shot.
And did you ever, at any point, did you clip each other? Because that can happen, can't it? If you know, if you're, and I know you're
clip
careful.
Clip being the exact word.
Yeah.
Clip being the word, you know, a couple of little clips. Nothing major at all. And, you know, we're there wanting to kill each other, you know, smashing each other around, pretending to break each other's arms, all this stuff. And then it goes cut and you go, are you right, dude?
Yeah.
You okay? Is everything, oh my God, did I catch you? Oh, I'm so sorry. You know, and we're like hugging like little girls. So, you know, it's a very safe environment.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, do you come away though? Because there's so much action in it and so it's so physical. Did you come away sort of bruised?
Not a scratch. You know, I mean, the worst that happened was a little graze.
Yeah.
Partly because everybody's so safe.
Yeah.
And they're so worried about their lead yes. actors, to be honest.
It's hard for me to ask you about your character and if there would be another one and if you would want to do it again. Mm-hmm. But I'm going to ask you anyway, Ed.
Well, it's always a possibility with Marvel. The honest answer is I don't know.
Yeah.
In the comics, Ajax comes back with an all-singing, all-dancing adamantium suit and all of this crazy stuff.
Yeah.
If this is my only dance with Deadpool, I'm thankful for it. If I get another dance with Deadpool, I'm thankful for it.
Perfect.
So it's all good.
Lovely. And the suit sounds fun. It's been absolutely lovely. Thank you so much. Lovely to meet you. And good luck. So Deadpool, and it's out now. And I liked it. Valentine's. Good for Valentine's.
But we joke, but I actually think it is. I mean, I came out from the screen. I was like, this actually is just a love story.
Yeah.
There's other bits on the side, comedy and darkness and violence, but it's a love story. So yeah, Valentine's Day. It's been scoring really high, testing really high with women as well. So, you know, it's I really hope people enjoy it.